This is my Windows PC. It's got NVIDIA inside, GeForce, and that grants us access to the NVIDIA GeForce experience, which, how would I describe it? It's a very proprietary package of drivers and goodies and other fun tools with maximum compatibility with your fancy new NVIDIA GPU. The app also gives you this fun game launcher, which I never use. And besides, I'm much more interested in this game stream setting. What's that? The NVIDIA game stream protocol was originally designed by NVIDIA for their Shield products. It's a very proprietary implementation that enables low latency video streaming and audio streaming. It also handles mouse and keyboard and controller inputs. It's basically just NVIDIA's way of enabling a remote gaming setup, which is pretty cool. And you'll notice that the game stream setting is disabled for me, and that's because I don't need to use the very proprietary experience app in order to do game stream stuff. This is Sunshine. Sunshine is a free and open source implementation of the server-side aspect of the NVIDIA game stream protocol. They reverse engineered it, and it's pretty swell. So what I have is a server package that I can run on my computer, in this case Windows, and I can grant access to remote clients which applications they can run remotely, graphically even. So I've given access to the desktop and Steam. So if you know how to speak the game stream protocol, then you can connect to my machine. This is my T450. It's running NetBSD. And a few days ago, I ported over to package source a package called Moonlight. And Moonlight is a free and open source client implementation of the NVIDIA game stream protocol. So maybe you'll see where this is going. Two Rivers is the name of the Windows machine. And if we log in, we see that the desktop and Steam are the two programs on Two Rivers that we are permitted to launch. So what if we launch Steam from NetBSD? Hey, that's pretty cool. And so here I am on the NetBSD machine, and we can come on. I was hoping to show the, well, yeah, this works. Can you see that? This is very difficult with one hand. The latency is not perfect, and that's mostly because the H.264 decoding hardware in here is quite inadequate. But I can do stuff. It's pretty compelling, in my opinion.